In this video, we are going to learn how to use text join function in Office 365. If you remember a function concatenate or end symbol in your Excel, so text join is going to respond in same manner as the as concatenate is doing. Now I'm going to just describe text join arguments over here, and if you will see carefully on the screen, here we have 1, 2, 3. So basically three are fixed argument and other are optional, and if you will see, it has infinite argument. You can see dot dot dot. So if you will see, delimiter means text string, means how you want to concatenate your text. In concatenate we generally didn't have this. Now what is here delimiter? Let's say if you want to join your let's say if here is your first name and here is your last name, and you want to join your first and last name and make it as a full name, so you can join with space. So that is called as text string. Now ignore empty, the name is very clear. Do you want to ignore your empty? So you need to give true or false. So here is text 1 and text 2 and 3, so on. So let's begin with text join. Now here, if you will see the example, here I have first name and here is we have last name. Now what I am going to do, I am going to build a one cell formula to concatenate all the name. So let's try text join. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to use text join. So here is text join. Now delimiter means space. Since I want to join my name with space, so I need to enter that space in double quote, comma. It is asking me, do you want to ignore empty? Yes, I am going to ignore my empty cells. Now it is asking me text 1, text 2, text 3. So let's begin and let's select whole range and let's check whether it is working or not. Since we are working in one cell formula. Now what is meaning of one cell formula? We can't use other cells. We need to enter a whole formula in only single cell. So that's how it is going to respond. Office 365 has a feature of spilled that can respond to your one cell formula. You need to just enter the formula in one cell. It will automatically spill the formula in other cell and automatically update. Now, if I will press enter, that I don't want over here. See what it has done. It has basically concatenated all the thing. First name, last name, first name, last name, first name, last name. But I don't want this. What I want basically, if you will see here, what I want this name. This name should be concatenated here. This name should be here. This name should be here. So what I want concatenation of every name in every other cell. So one option is you can simply drag and drop. You can concatenate first two cells. And you can do drag and drop, but I don't want drag and drop because we are learning Office 365 and we are using one cell formula approach. Now in that case, we need to use a new function that is called by row. Now let me show you what by row does. If you will see by row, here we have by row. So let's say here, let me just take my example. And I am going to generate some random numbers here. So let's say here we have 100, 999. So here I am taking random numbers. Now I am simply copying it and pasting it as values. Now I am removing my formula. I have removed my formula. Now what I need to do? I need to do the summation. How I want the summation? Summation means I want summation in every single cell. So basically what I want the summation of these three cell. These three cell here. And these three cell here. So that's how I'm going to use my by row. So basically by row is going to work with every row, and that is going to build our one cell formula. So that's how by row can respond. So by row, so here is my array. Array means your data. Now comma, if you will see here, it has some bit function in it. You can see sum. So if I will use simply sum function, it is going to build a summation. And if you don't have that function, what which do you want? For example, if I'm talking about this example, here we want what? Here we want text split. So here we don't have any text split in by row. If you will see here, we don't have any text split. So what we need to do, we need to build our custom function and custom function can be built using lambda. So we will try lambda and we will concatenate all the name in every other row. So what I will do, I was doing a summation, so I'm simply entering sum here and close the parentheses and enter. Now you will see it has done the summation in every cell, but I have used only one cell. It is automatically spilling the formula. If you will see formula bar here, it is little bit light in color. So here and it is dark. So I am entering formula only in M5 and it is automatically spilling in other cells. So that's how one cell formula is going to work. So let's try the same concept here. So I'm going to use by row. Array means your data. So I'm going to select it, lock it. Again, locking part is not important because we are using one cell formula. So what I have done, let me just show you once again what I have done. So I have used by row and I have simply select this array. Now you will see I am at the last row of my data, but I don't want that. I want to switch my cursor to top. So either we have one option, we can switch from this to top, and we can simply press F4 key, that will lock our range and automatically go on top. And you will see I have simply pressed F4 and it is on top. Now what I need to do, I need to build a function. Here I have already shown you that text split is not here. So what I will do, I will use lambda. Now lambda. Now open the parentheses. Now it is asking me two things, parameter or calculation. Now if I will put comma, 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 and you will see it has infinite argument. You can put multiple thing in it, parameter or calculation, parameter or calculation, parameter and calculation. Now what is your parameter? Now how lambda is going to work? We need to presume our array, like for example, I am presuming my array is x. So whole array would be treated as x. So I am entering x here. Now first you need to give parameters. Parameter, or you can also call it as variables if you are in from programming background. So here what I am thinking, so basically this range I'm treating it as x. Now what I need to do, I need to use text join. Now delimiter means space, comma. Do you want to ignore empty? Yes, I want to ignore it. True, comma. And text is, since I have already presumed all array is x, so I am entering x as my text. Now close the parentheses. So you will see this is my parameter variable and this whole thing is my calculation. So parameter and calculation, other thing are optional, you can ignore it. So close the parentheses and enter. I need to close one more parenthesis here and enter. So you will see it has concatenated all the name in that manner in which you want. So that's the name I want. So it is getting those names. Now use the same concept and I'm going to use text join once again. Now what I want to take this example to one step further. Now you will see here is my full name and here is my IDs. Now what I want my data to be like this. So if you will see, full name minus ID means I want to concatenate what? I need to concatenate column using minus sign, or basically, and I want to concatenate my rows with hash. So if you will see, full name minus ID hash this name minus this one hash minus this one. So that's how it is going to work over here. So if we will use the same concept, so what it is going to do, it is going to concatenate a full name ID, this one, this one, this one, this one, and it is going to split in other cells. So let's try to do the same concept once again. So I'm going to use by row once again. By row and array, I'm selecting my data. F4 if you want to come at the top. If you don't want to lock it, let's say I am not locking this time, I'm simply using my mouse and coming at the top, comma. Here I'm building my own function, that is lambda. Now I am again presuming my whole array is x, comma, and I need to use text join. Now since I want column should be concatenated with your minus sign. So what I will do, I will enter minus sign in my delimiter, because minus sign is your text. So that's why I am entering that minus sign in double quote. Now true, comma, and what is your text? Whole array is has already been assumed as x. So x is your array. Close the parentheses, and close the parentheses. Now how we will we'll know how many times we need to close the parentheses. Let me remove the parentheses once again. Now if you will see here, the formula is showing, right? So if I will put the parentheses once, another formula is showing, right? If I will put the second one, another formula is showing. If I will put the last one, and you can see now the formula is not coming, even the screen tip is not coming. It means I have done with my parentheses. I can simply press my enter. Now you will see all name has concatenated with ID, but I don't want that. Now I want one more thing in it. I need to concatenate all the rows as well using hash. So I'm going to use text join once again in the same formula. So I am simply editing it, and again I can't use other cell. I need to use only one cell. That is the one cell formula concept. So text join, and sorry, text join here, delimiter means hash, comma, ignore empty, true, comma, mistakenly by row has deleted. So I am entering by row once again. So this was our formula, and we need to put the parentheses once again and enter. Now you will see the same concept we want here, and it is giving me the same concept. So this is your text join. That's how text join is going to respond in multiple cell. Now let's begin our text split. So if you will see the argument of text split, what text split does? So basically, let's say you have full name and you want to split your name. Now in this text split function, you can split that kind of thing using column delimiter, row delimiter. Now here we have ignore empty, match mode, and pad width. If you will read the argument, and I have taken this from the Microsoft website. So what you can do, text is, what do you want to split? Column delimiter. If you want to split your columns, then you can use column delimiter. If you want to split your rows, then you can use row delimiter. Ignore empty, true and false, and match mode. Here we need to perform, if you want to, let's say, split your case sensitive, then you can enter your match mode. If you are entering 1, then it means it is not case sensitive, and if you are entering 0, then it means case sensitive. So pad width means, what if you are getting errors? So that that's how you can presume it as if error. So if there would be error, how you want to tackle those errors? So now I'm going to use the text split in this example. Here is the full name, and I'm going to use text split. And again, I'm going to select my text. I can't use other cells. I need to use one cell only. Now text split, here it is, comma, column delimiter. If you will see, column delimiter means how you want to split your columns, and you will see all name is concatenated with your space. So I need to enter space in double quotes and close the parentheses. Is that we want? No. So if we are selecting whole range, so text split is not working. And what if I'm going to use by row? So let's try a by row. Array, select your data, lock it to come on top. Now comma, here we need to use function. So I'm going to use lambda. I'm treating my whole range as x, comma, and I'm going to use text split. And here is my text means your range. So x is your range, comma, delimiter means space, close the parentheses, and close the parentheses, enter. Now it is not working as well. It means by row cannot perform in text split. So now in text split, there is a problem. How we can deal this kind of problem if we are building one cell formula? One option is you can simply put your formula in one cell and drag and drop, but I don't want that. What I want to build one cell formula. So simply what I will do, I will concatenate all the rows, then I will use text split. Let me show you how. So I am simply using text join first. So what text join is going to do? Text join is going to concatenate all the rows like this. So delimiter, let's say I am not using space because space is already entered in my data. So let's say I am entering hash. And do you want to ignore empty true, comma, and you need to select your text now. So I'm going to select it, close the parentheses and enter. Now you will see my whole data has been concatenated with hash key. And you can see now there are two symbols, space hash, space hash, space hash. So that's how my data is going to concatenate. Now I am going to split my data using text split. If you will see, text split has two things, column delimiter, row delimiter. So I can use both the thing. Now I'm going to use text split. So here whole the thing is my text, comma, column delimiter. If you will see, my column is concatenated with what? Spaces. So I'm entering space. Row delimiter we have entered manually, that is your hash key. Don't forget to use double quote. Now close the parentheses and enter. So that's how we are going to split our full name. So some for text split we need to use text join. So here we have one that example. Once again the answer is same. If you want to, let's say you want to make this data into this form, we can use text split. So let's try here text split, and text is here, comma, column delimiter. If you will see, all data is concatenated with minus sign. So minus, comma, and here we am entering hash. The same example, close the parentheses and enter. Now see, this data has changed into this shape. So that's how we can reverse our data into back in back in shape. So that's how it is going to respond. Now let's try to understand two more function over here of 365, that is text before and text after. And you will see text before. So basically, if you want to split any text before a specific text, let's say I want to split a text before a space, then you can split your text before, then you can use your text before. So text before have multiple argument. If you will see, text is what do you want to split, delimiter means how you want to split your data. If there would be space, I would be I'm going to split my data using space and any other symbol. And instance number means do you want to split from the beginning or do you want to split from the end. If you are entering positive number, then it is going to start from the beginning. Let's say I'm entering plus one, so it is going to start from left to right. And if you are entering minus one, then it is going to read your data from right to left. So that's how it is going to respond. Match mode. So basically match mode means case sensitive or case insensitive. One is non-case sensitive, zero is case sensitive. Match end, I will show you this in example. If not found, this is your if error. What if the text is not found, what do you want? So here I am going to take my example, and here we have our text after. Let's say what I want to split my first name using text before. So let's say text before. You can ignore this name, I have mistakenly written it as wrong. So if you will see, text before and text after both has same arguments, but the difference is text before is going to split your text from a specific character, and text after is going to split a text after your specific character. So let's say text is this one, comma, delimiter, how your text is concatenating. So with space it is concatenating, and close the parentheses and enter. Now it is NA because there is no space in it. And if I will simply drag and drop, and you will see it is splitting fine, but I don't want to drag and drop because we are using one cell formula. So what we need to do, we need to simply remove this before and select the whole range and enter. Now you will see the first name is already extracting. Now how to fix this NA? We can use if error, otherwise we have one more option. Let's say what you want, what you can do, you can simply remove the if error and concatenate the header by using vstack. And what else we can do here, if you will see, instance number is के बेसिकली डू यू वॉन्ट टू स्टार्ट विथ बिगिनिंग और एंड, लेट्स से इफ यू वॉन्ट टू एक्सट्रैक्ट द लास्ट नेम, और लेट्स से इफ यू वॉन्ट टू रीड योर डेटा लाइक दिस. So if I'm going to enter minus one, so it is not going to split this Alexander. It is going to split what? It is going to split the first two name. So it is going to start. It is going to start reading from the end. So that's how it is going to read. So it is going to take this space, and before is this one. So that how it is going to respond. But still, I'm pressing Control Z to come back. Here we have instance number. I don't want instance number. Match mode, case sensitive, in case sensitive. I don't want that. Now this is I want to explain here. Now if you will see, it is showing don't match to end and match to end. Now if I will enter one here, and let's check what it is doing. It is taking name. Now how it is achieving this name in while we don't have any space in it? How if we enter one in it? Now what one is doing here? One is presuming. Now one is virtually entering what? One is virtually entering space at the end of every character. So if you will see name, and if we will concatenate space with it, so name space, and if we extract text before, so what is written before space? That is name. So that's how it is going to respond here. And if you will see the if you will read the text of your Microsoft website, so it is going to treat the end of the text as delimiter. So that's how it is going to respond. So this is the text before. Now one more example I want to cover here. I want to extract middle name using text before and text after. We can do that, and let's try to do that using text before. So I'm going to use text before first. So let's say I want to extract middle name. So that's how I'm going to select this text, comma, delimiter space, comma. This time I'm not going to start from the beginning. I'm going to start from the end. And here it is. Now it has extracted what? First name and second name. Now I want second name. I'm going to use text after. Text after. And text is, this whole thing is your text, comma, double quotes. And close the parentheses and enter. And if you will see what it has done after space, what is written? Your middle name. So that's how it is going to extract your middle name. Now we can fix this NA, or we can write if error function, like if there would be error, then this time I'm using if error. So I want to enter name, or you can make it blank. So let's say here is a name. If there would be multiple blank, then I would use the old method to deal with these kind of problems. So this is your text join, text split, text after and text before. See you in next video. Till then, you can subscribe the channel. Keep enjoying and keep learning.